Hey guys, Trevor Morris here. Welcome to Ask Me Anything.
Hello, Trevor, my talented friend. This is Sean Callery here. I have two questions. One that's not musical, one musical. I've always wanted to know what your favorite cigar is. I don't think you've ever told me. And secondly, what is the best TV show theme out there? And by the way, you can't choose a theme that you won an Emmy for, okay? Thank you. Bye.
Sean Callery. You know what? Here's my problem with you, my friend. You know the good, fast, cheap triangle, pick any two? So are you talented, handsome, or smart? Kind of all three, I guess, right? I'm just kidding. Come on in the studio, guys. Thanks, Sean. Ask me anything. Wow, this is fun. Something different. I like it. You know, my journey with cigars started somewhere in the 90s, I think, whenever the movie Swingers came out. I've never smoked a cigarette in my life. It's not my thing. But when Swingers came out, the idea of smoking cigars became cool and was kind of new for me. I remember going down to the local deli on Bloor Street, just because that was where I knew they had cigars. But you got to realize at this time, there was no trade embargo with Cuba from Canada. I was living in Toronto. So I just said, what's good? And he pulls up all the biggest, greatest hits of Cuban cigars. You know, Monte Cristo this, and Romeo and Julieta that, and Punch and Upin, and I didn't know. I just said, give me something that I'll enjoy. So fast forward, when I moved to LA, I moved into this area, east side of LA, called Los Feliz Village, which is where the movie Swingers is shot. The Dresden Room, the par 3 golf course, and the deli, and all that. It's hysterical. A little full circle there. But segue to how this reconnects with Sean. So I was working on one of my first television shows. By the way, I had heard Sean's name back 10 years earlier when I was living in Toronto. He was doing a show called, I think it was La Femme Nikita, which was posting in Toronto. So I already knew his name. I already knew his work. So fast forward 10 years later, I'm doing one of my first shows and it's airing on Fox. And I just thought the mixes sounded like monkey butt. I was really disappointed with the sound of it. And meanwhile, the juggernaut that was 24, the Emmy sweeping machine that it was in full force. And Sean was obviously the man at the moment then. Still is, of course. So I asked my agent at the time, I called her up and I said, could you introduce me to Sean? I wouldn't mind just picking his brain. So she did. And I said, hey man, nice to meet you. I love your stuff. Your score kicks ass on TV. Mine sounds like shit. Any thoughts? Can I have all your sample libraries and your synclavier patches while I'm at it? joking. And out of that became a friendship. And we found that we have a mutual interest in having a cigar once in a while. It's sort of a social relaxation thing. And we would go to a cigar bar in Beverly Hills every 3 weeks or something in the middle of the afternoon, because it was the slowest, and we'd sit down, we'd have a cigar, maybe a cup of coffee, maybe a cocktail, whatever, and we would just sort of open up and get down to it, and, you know, composers getting out of their dark rooms and having a chance to just, you know, bullshit with each other and say, hey, what's up? Family is what's up, or career, or this. So it was a really great time to slow down and just chill, and the cigar was the connective tissue between Sean and I that way. So what is my favorite cigar? Okay, I'm gonna do this ghetto style. Hopefully this works. It's my humidor. So here's my cigar humidor. These are non-Cubans. And over here we have the Monte Cristo number 2, the king of cigars. Another quick story about this particular cigar that I really like telling is I was working for, so my filmmaking heroes, not film music, but filmmaking heroes are Ridley and Tony Scott. They're just my kind of directors and make the kind of movies I've always loved watching. And I've met Ridley a couple times through other circumstances and had dinner with him. But I was working on a Scott-free production called The Pillars of the Earth. And I had a meeting at the RSA headquarters in Hollywood, and Ridley was there and Tony was there. And Tony, who just, the late great Tony, of course, who just exuded this energy about him. He would walk around with a cut Monte Cristo number 2 in his hand all day, just like this, as if waiting for some moment of a finish line of the day, or I don't know, whatever. I know Ridley enjoys a good cigar too. So it was just a memorable thing to watch, to meet him for the first time. And he was doing his movie, and he was producing the television series, this mini series that I was doing. So that's my Monte Cristo story. Reminds me of my buddy Sean, and it reminds me of Tony Scott as well. And yes, I'm going to smoke this, in case you're wondering. I'm not sure if that's PC or not. Who cares? Nice. Ooh, my studio's going to stink tomorrow. So, that's cigars covered, I think. That reminds me. Didn't you say Nathan Barr is into cigars? Maybe we should have a Zoom, cigar Zoom, best we can do in COVID lockdown. Main title music. That's a great question. You know what? I am such a huge fan of main title music. I always have been. And, you know, you think of how deep that history goes. There was a situation a couple years ago where the Television Academy was thinking about eliminating the main title Emmy Award. Emmy, for those who don't know what that is, it's kind of the Oscars, but for television, just our highest award for TV. And we fought it, and ultimately we won, and it's still around, which is great. But, you know, main titles aren't as in fashion as they used to be. But which I'll never understand, you know, I just, especially with streaming models where there's no advertising dollars, I don't understand why they wouldn't put 90 seconds to a main title. I mean, think of the shows, I don't know how old you are, what you grew up with, whether it be, you know, Hawaii 5-0 or, you know, the Jetsons or the Simpsons, the Brady Bunch with the 9 squares. Almost everyone can sing that one. I remember when NYPD Blue came out, I was like, what is that? Is that drums? Is it a subway? Is it sound design? It was just like so captivating and interesting. And of course, all the Jerry Goldsmith Star Treks, you know. And for sure, for me, one of the icons of the 90s was James Newton Howard's theme to ER. I mean, ER was the first really must-watch television show. I remember just glued to that for 10 seasons. And that main title never got old. I loved it. Still do. Can still play it on the piano right now. So I think, you know, and then Ramin did a great job with Game of Thrones, which is, of course, so iconic because the series was so successful. He's performed it in concert, too. So just imagine, you know, what we would have been robbed out of if we didn't have some of those main titles, you know, whether it be Star Trek or Game of Thrones or whatever. So I'm a huge fan of them, and I hope that they live long and prosper. But in terms of picking... Walk with me to the piano, shall we? In terms of picking one of the all-time greats, that's a tough ask, man. There's a lot of good main title music out there. But see if this one rings a bell. That would ring a bell, Sean? Anyway. Awesome question, man. I like it. Keep it light. It was fun. I'll see you soon, pal. Be safe. And everybody else, thanks for tuning in. And this is Ask Me Anything. So give me a shot. Give me a shout out and shoot me a video. And let's keep it going. It's fun talking to you guys. All right. Take care. Thank you.
Thank you.